Hey guys, it's Travis Ryan. I'm a worship pastor at Life Point Church in Smyrna, Tennessee. Today, I want to give you 6 tips for leading your worship rehearsals. Number one is prayer. You must start your rehearsals with prayer. Prayer changes atmosphere. Prayer aligns our hearts with the Father's heart. It is very important before we step into this gathering with God's people that our hearts are right before the Lord, that God's will and the Father's will would be done more than our very own will. So prayer is numero uno. That's very important. Number two is give vision. God's word says where there is no vision, the people perish. What that talks about is vision is his word. Vision is his word. So give vision. Where are we going today as a team? What's the mountain that we are gonna take? What's the hill that we're gonna climb together as we, as a team are growing? Where are we going as a team? So give vision, that's number two. Number three is practice worship. Practice worship. Okay, so as a team, obviously we know that worship is our lives, and we're not just taking worship as this moment of singing, but it's practicing his presence. And as a team, it's really important that we are not just going through songs and getting a song right, but it's being aware that he is near us, knowing that his presence is with us. And so we are practicing worship before we step in to the gathering with God's people. And we've spent time with him and we know where to go when he tells us to go and tells us to move. And we're following his lead all the way. That's number three. Number four is practice transitions. Practice your transitions. So from song one to song two, practice that. How is that transition? Is it going to be a cymbal from the drummer that is leading you into the next song? Is it going to be a key part? If it's just you on acoustic guitar and you're leading by yourself, how am I going to transition from the key of E to the key of B? Maybe you haven't thought that through. Maybe you need to change the key of the song to have that transition be smoother and not as distracting. Number five, practice your intros and your endings of songs. Where are we going? It's very important because if you don't know where you're going, the people and that moment will feel extremely awkward. You do not want that to be the case. You want this to be the most smooth and least distracting as possible. So practice your intros and your endings of songs. Number six. Practice change and flexibility. It is very important for you to not be the person who's holding back the reins on when God is moving. Now, I also have to say, when God moves, he will always win, and you will always lose. But practice that. Have your teams be flexible. Are your teams able to go from a song from that's been planned in the set, and you all of a sudden going, I'm gonna go into Here I Am to Worship, or I'm gonna go into 10,000 Reasons, or whatever that song may be, because that moment that God is moving requires a different song for that time. So practice change and practice flexibility. That is so important. So I hope these tips are very helpful for you. If you wanna check out more tips, go subscribe to We Are Worship TV.